Good morning, everyone. Before we start in today's class, I would like to ask you a question. What have we learned from last lesson? Anyone want to tell me the answer? Yes, Jonathan. Yes, appearance. We have learned about people's appearance last lesson. We learned how to describe people's hair, dress, clothes, like this. Now, we are going to learn about people's character and people's personality. At first, let's look at this question, please. What's this person like? What do this question mean? What's this person like? Anyone knows answers? No, it's not about people's appearance. Let's see the question. Two different questions. What's this person like? And what this person look like? What's the difference between them? What this person like? It's about people's personality. And the character. What does this person look like? It's about they want to know people's appearance.
Wow, this is a very good answer. I want to hear it. Cheerful.
students in our class? Who is a considered student in our class? Sarah, you are a considered student in our class. Considered means the person always consider other people's thoughts and think about other people's needs. Okay, let's see this for a second picture. We can say, he is funny. He is humorous. He is entertaining. He is cheerful. And we also can say he is very easygoing because he always smiles and looks he can be good at with all of the other people. All we can say this soldier is loyal, brave, responsible, and trustworthy. Do you think I'm a responsible teacher? No! Why? Why am I not a responsible teacher? Of course I'm a responsible teacher because I need to tell you the knowledge, I need to give you feedback on your homework. So I think I'm a responsible teacher. Let's see the next picture. We can use honest, reliable, and gentle to describe these two people. Of course, gentle, usually we use them to describe a man. We can see this man is very gentle, right? So now, you have many positive adjectives you can use to describe someone's personality. Choose one word and explain to your peers. And explain to your peers the understanding of the words and let her or let him get to guess what words you choose. Okay? I give you 2 minutes to discuss. You can choose any of one word from this vocabulary list and explain it. Okay? For example, I choose the word war. It's meaning someone who shows their positive feelings to other people. I tell my peers about this. I can start with this. I want to tell you a word. And this word means person always bring positive feelings to others and make other people feel good. What this word? What this word? And then your parents can say, I guess the word is. Please start these activities with your peers. Okay? Now we are familiar with these words, these good words to describe people's personality and character. We can use these words in our writing and our conversation during our daily life. But when we use this adjective, we need to put some details and reasons on that. For example, my friend Anna is a cheerful person, and my uncle is really humorous. Why my friend Anna is very cheerful? And why my uncle is humorous? Who can give me the answer? Anyone knows the answer? If your friend is a cheerful person, why you use the word cheerful to describe your friend? This is a very good answer. Let's see my answer together. My friend Anna is a cheerful person because she is always greeting with people, with smiling and in a good mood. My uncle is really humorous because he always tells me some funny jokes that make me laugh. Even though I'm in a bad mood, he can make me laugh and forget the senses. Now, it's your time to write a description about your friend or about your parents. Work with peers and follow this structure to write like 2 or 3 sentences enough. I hope I can get your homework before the next lessons.